with them over the year, Eduardo and Bethany Valenzuela. I'll have you both come up. Come on, Eduardo. He's being shy. He's trying to play shy. He's pretending to be shy. He's not shy. But we want to have you guys just greet everybody, say hello, and then I'll ask you a question you can jump off and go from there with.
Oh, hi. My name is Eduardo or Lalo, and this is my beautiful wife. We've been together for about 25 years. Yes, we were born together, and then
That's not true.
And we've been doing ministry for the past 16 years. We pastor a church here on the east side, San Jose. We are part of the House Modesto. We're an extension here on San Jose, and we've been doing great work in high school. So we've been praying for about 10 years to be able to get into high schools, and we weren't able to see any responses until just recently, and I just want my wife to tell you all about it because she gets really excited about it.
I told you he wasn't shy. You know, we're talking tonight and at our upcoming conference, it'll all be themed around the ecclesia, that is us understanding. We are really God's church, and we take his presence and his power everywhere. Bethany, tell us a little bit about what God has been doing on public high school campuses here in the new Bible Belt, San Jose, California.
It's really just an honor. Here we go. It's really an honor to be in the presence of so many amazing intercessors and generals in this room. And so thank you so much. We wouldn't be here in this place if it wasn't for decades or even the turn of the century of intercessors and fathers and mothers and generals that are been crying and praying for revival for the youth. And so we're just humbled and honored right now. And so when we came to San Jose and we planted this church, we asked the Lord, we're like, God, how can we reach this city and see transformation? And the Lord spoke to us and said, I will use the youth as a springboard to reestablish families. And so we're like, okay, what does that mean? And so we entered into a high school, and it's crazy because we just started being consistent and just loving on these kids, and that consistency started to build trust, and that trust now brought and birthed curiosity. Yeah. And so we are so excited because we are on assignment to bring the presence of God to this school, not just students, but the faculty and the administration, and God is sabotaging their reality. They think that their reality is abuse and pain and loneliness and death and every other thing that the enemy has to throw at them. But God's reality is, no, you have been called with a purpose, and he is now rising up these youth, and they are going out and seeing, wow, I can transform my school. And so we have seen 1,400 kids just in this school year. We've been doing this for about 1,400 students.
You're going to have to say it really slow. We're here in California here. We want to make sure everybody hears this.
We have seen 1,400 students.
1,400. Yes.
Close to that.
She didn't say 40.
We've seen so many other salvations before that.
Praise
but
God.
Just in this school year, they have publicly declared that they want Jesus Christ to be their Lord and Savior.
Amen. Amen.
So the statistics in America is that around 80% of high school students will receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior before they graduate.
Yeah. Amen.
And so this is the greatest mission field. And if you want to calculate the thousands and thousands of churches across this nation and organizations across this nation, less than 1% is responding to the greatest mission field in America, which are these high schools. It's the lowest hanging fruit. And so this is the generation where it's motherless and fatherless. And so I encourage you to get up, send your youth pastor, send somebody to adopt these campuses, because God is doing something radical. We've seen other organizations and churches doing things like this, but it's just less than 1% of what we can get others to respond to. And so we are very, very privileged and honored. And we met Jason Ma, and Jason Ma says, you know what? I walked around the campus that you're at least 100 times. And so when we went on that campus, in a couple weeks, we did a hope rally, and more than 700 kids showed up.
Wow.
And so the kids are responding to the gospel.
Yes.
It is possible.
Yeah.
They just need somebody to say, yes, I will do it. I will make this happen push the kingdom of God forward.
Come on. That's so good, Bethany.
Yes.
So, folks, I hope you capture this. It's happening. It's happening here. We are God's ecclesia, and it's harvest time. The harvest is ripe. Jesus' words in Luke chapter 10 are applicable today. The harvest is plentiful. Everybody say that with me. The harvest is plentiful.
And I just want to close with one little short testimony. I'm a little exhausted because we just came back from a wild youth conference that Stadium Modesto put on. We just came back this morning. And so we saw so many Northern California churches come together, bring their high school students. They have been radically wrecked by the presence of God. Amen. Hearts were healed. The spirit of offense was cast out. Yokes were broken. And it was crazy because the calling was being awakened.
Yes.
And one kid that we brought from one of many kids that we brought to this conference, he never walked into a church. He never has come to a youth conference. No. Nothing like that ever in his life. No. And yesterday morning, he goes, Bethany, he goes, ever since this morning, I just feel like I've been so light. I'm really light.
Yes.
Like if I lost like 100 pounds, he goes, I'm walking, I feel so light. I'm like if you're walking on a cloud. He goes, yeah, like I'm walking on a cloud. Why do I feel like this? And I says, when you encounter the presence of God, he starts breaking the yoke. And he goes, oh, wow. Oh, he goes, so all my peers at school can feel this light too?
Yes.
And I said, absolutely.
Amen.
He goes, when I go into the school in 3 weeks, he says, I will never stop preaching the presence of the Lord.
Come on.
And his friend just committed suicide, his best friend, and his dad got in a car accident and died.
Wow.
So he has a lot going on in his life, but he has hope.
Yes.
And so God's been healing his past,
yes,
and there's hope for the future. So thank you guys once again.
Amen. Thank you so much, you guys. Thank you for sharing that. That is awesome.